What's going on, guys? Hockey season's rolling along. We're about a quarter of the way through the season already. Pretty crazy. A couple cards, I think, being left behind, so we're going to take a look at them. I'm going to call them the high roller cards because, you know, this isn't basketball. They're not $10,000 cards, anything like that, but they're not inexpensive cards. So first guy we're going to take a look at is Mitch Marner. We're going to look at all of these in PSA 10. So he had 1 point in his first 7 games and then 16 points in the next 14 games after that. Got off to a bit of a slow start, but Toronto, you know, in a good position for the playoffs. If you want some sort of safety net, you know, you can take a look at Mitch Marner as, you know, a playoff play, but I don't think it's going to take that long for this card to come back up. We'll take a look a little bit longer and see where it's come from. So it's come down from here, you know, up at about $890, $900, like a $900 card, and then it floated over the summertime when I said it was a great time to buy. I think still would have been a great time to buy. That's around $500. You know, you see a low sale down here at $433, but right around the $500 mark, and right now it's sitting at about the $570 mark. As Mitch Marner continues to put up the numbers, you know, I think we're going to see that price continue to go up. And the market, it's just the way that the market's been. You take a look at a guy like Troy Terry, the market is really latching on to players, being super reactive and latching on to players who put up points. Mitch Marner is one of the guys who's going to get the attention. You know, he's a point per game player, and that's what we want to be investing in and buying. Next guy we're going to take a look at, injured, playing for your Vegas Golden Knights. Last sale, 180 days. We're going to take a look at the 180 day. That was a 365. So 180 day low at $307 for the PSA 10. You know, this one you might want to be a little bit careful with. You can make an argument, you know, you could wait, maybe it'll drop a little bit more, but I think it's at a really good spot here. If you can get it at the 300 US dollar mark, you're not going to be doing too bad for yourself. If you're a real baller, then I would buy one at 300, and if it continues to dip down to say 250, you know, maybe pick up another one there. Now you have two Eichel PSA 10s. I don't think that's going to work out poorly for you at all. I think is a real opportunity. You know, this guy's 40 goal scorer. He's going to do it over point per game. You know, last two seasons, 150. What's that? 160 points in about 155 games. Over point per game, goal scorer. That's what you want. When guys are hurt, you know, they forget about. When guys are hurt, the market just generally forgets about them, and that's what we got going on here with Jack Eichel. Last player, we got my boy Nathan MacKinnon. Again, injured. Started off first 8 games. Put up 10 points, shooting at 4.35%, so not much going on there, but it's Nathan MacKinnon. Same thing, we'll take a look. 180-day low, last sale at $995, so below that $1,000 mark, which is pretty crazy. We'll take a look at where he came from. You know, back at the peak, he was up over $2,000, and even last season, you know, running up to the playoffs, up to about the $1,800 mark. So when we're down at the $995 mark, 180-day low, I'm really liking that. I got a couple MacKinnons here. I'm stuck holding them, but this is certainly a play that I think will work out really well for people. This is, you know, arguably top two player in the NHL down at $995 just because he isn't playing. But there you go, guys. Hit that like button below. Subscribe up. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it. And we'll check you.